It's over. But Zephyr's still gone.
Focus on the positive. We defeated a lord. And under difficult circumstances, too.
Focus on the positive? Zephyr's dead, Shion.
And the Renans ruled this world unimpeded for 3 centuries. Did you think there wouldn't be any sacrifices?
So Zephyr's life just doesn't matter? He's dead, Shion. Our friend is dead. We're fighting this damn war to keep people alive!
Yeah, you're right. This is a war. Did you just realize that? Zephyr wasn't the first to die, and he sure won't be the last. If you can't handle that, Alphen, then you should run back to Calaglia. And when you do, just remember to leave the Blazing Sword here, in safer hands.
What's that supposed to mean? Damn it. She just thinks she can say whatever she likes. Bickering among ourselves at a time like this isn't gonna get us anywhere. Especially at a time like this. All right. Fine.
So much for Ganabelt. Good riddance.
You said it.
So, was the Lord of Calaglia like Ganabelt too?
No. Balsef was huge, a real tough guy act. Now that I think of it, his crest was different too. His was a flaming cross.
Ah, I see. Anyway, what do you guys plan on doing from here?
We keep moving. 3 Renan lords remain, and we won't rest until their thrones are empty as well. That work for you, Shion?
That was my endgame from the beginning.
Hey, so if it's not too much trouble, could I maybe come along?
Isn't Cislodia your home?
I mean, yes, but it's just, now that everyone knows what I've been hiding, well, it might be best to get as far away as I can until it all quiets down. Is that okay? I promise I'll pull my own weight.
Sure. You're welcome to join us.
Taking off, huh?
Yeah. Thanks for everything.
It's too bad. I wish there was more we could do to pay you back for all you've done. I'll see to it personally that Zephyr's remains reach Calaglia safely.
What's next for Cislodia?
I honestly couldn't tell you. The enemy infiltrated its way right to our core as a people. Only time will tell if we can rise above our suspicions and come together.
Zephyr once told me that so long as you don't give up, there's no wall that can't be torn down.
Sounds about right. And thanks to you, the greatest obstacle that was in our way is now gone. I suppose the rest of it will be up to us.
I look forward to seeing how far you'll go.
Oh, I almost forgot. Before you head off, there's something I wanted to give you.
Scrub up real nice.
It was a parting gift.
It's like speaking to one of the old Danon heroes from legend.
Where to next, then?
Elda Menencia. You're really going to travel in that thing?
Why not? It's not as heavy as it looks. Actually, there's someone I was hoping we could invite along with us.
You can't be serious.
Got some place to be?
Not really. I mean, I can't stay here, of course. Then again, there's no one waiting for me back in Calaglia either. Plenty of ditches along the road. Maybe I'll find one to die in.
How about a fresh start?
After the kinds of things I've done, I don't know where I'd even begin.
Your father said that as long as you face the past, there's hope.
I think it might be a little late for that.
He also said he'd fought and lost all his life, but didn't regret it in the slightest. It's only over when you give up. Keep fighting, and even that wall inside you can be brought down. Don't you want to see what your dad saw on the other side of that wall? What he was fighting for?
Do you think I'm even worthy to?
That's for you to decide.
I'm sick of losing everything I love. Of running from life. Maybe all that's left is to just turn around and face it. Count me in.
Finally, I thought you'd never finish. We've still got a ways to go.
Here we go, Hoodle.
This armor was a gift from Bregan. What if it really did belong to a Danon hero once upon a time? He challenged an overwhelmingly powerful Renan foe. And perished for it. I wonder how he felt having the hopes of the people riding on him.
Hey, did you make off with that armor while none of us were looking? Because I've gotta admit, you look pretty snazzy in it.
He didn't steal it, if that's what you mean. Bregan gave it to him as a parting gift.
Ah, right. Although it makes sense, I guess. It's like a symbol of rebellion in its own way.
Which is why it should have been your father wearing this, not me.
I don't know. I don't think he could have pulled it off like you, man.
I wonder what the last wearer of this armor was dreaming of for Cislodia when they decided to rise up and fight.
Who knows? Anyone who could have answered that is long gone. Truth is always lost with the departed.
Are you saying there's no point in trying to understand why they gave up their lives?
No. Only that it's impossible to know for sure. Look, I can tell that you're concerned about Cislodia's future. But we do have other things to take care of. You can't shoulder all of the world's problems, Alphen. If you try to, you'll only find yourself buried by the weight of it all.
Yeah, I know. My path is forward, and I'll do what I can, here and now.
You were born in Calaglia, right, Law?
Hmm? Oh yeah, it's scalding hot all the time there, so I was shocked when I learned Cislodia is the exact opposite. Not to mention dark.
Not anymore, thankfully.
How did you even manage to cross the border between realms? All five realms are supposed to be closed off, due to the nature of the crown contest.
What? Is this an interrogation now?
I didn't mean it like that. I just figured if a Danon like you was able to slip between realms, it could come in handy later.
Ah, good thinking. I don't think I really did anything all that creative, though.
What? Don't tell me you climbed over the walls of fire.
Oh, hell no. Not even Zoogles could do something that crazy. Nah, I stowed away.
In what?
Oh, you'll like this. The realms don't maintain much contact with each other, but there are resources each is looking to trade for. So, there are cargo convoys from each of the lords that go around a few times a year to lend those resources to each other.
Oh yeah, I remember hearing about that. That was the only time the gates of Calaglia would ever open up.
Right. Obviously, they don't let Danons ride with them. So I snuck on board inside some cargo instead.
So you were carried out of the realm? You did great not getting caught. Way to go.
Let's just say I've always had a knack for sneaking around since I was little. I was also really desperate to get the hell out of Calaglia at the time. I had more guts than brains that day. If I had a guess, I probably wasn't the first one to ever do something like that. Danon or Renan.
I wonder if that's how Ganabelt, was able to hear about what happened in Calaglia so quickly.
So in other words, we should always assume that the enemy is informed about whatever it is that we may be up to, wherever we go.
Where does that drawbridge connect to?
No idea, but I've seen it get lowered. It can't be lowered from this side anyway, so it's useless to us.
He's gone!
Take this!
Mega Ray!
Come and face me!
Gemini,
we are breaking invincible!
These Alphen and the others truly are strong!
What about me?
Do it!
Wish they were all that easy.
Yeah, I think we might be getting too strong.
Isn't that good?
Play along, would you?
A blip on our radar.
I'm backing down!
There!
Talon Storm!
This one's mine! In here!
You're mine!
This'll come
Severing in Wind!
This one's all mine!
We're trying to keep up with the
wall!
You're
finished!
The tide of battle has turned. That's the power of comrades in arms.
Take right. This!
Comrades in arms. What? Too sentimental?
Win!
Hold up. Is this as valuable as I think it is? This looks nice and tough.
I won't forgive you! Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
It's on!
This one's mine!
Well, we're on the home stretch now.
Don't take your eyes off the prize.
I'm quite a man!
My fists are crushing it out there!
What's wrong?
Really? Sure.
Hey.
Right.
Right. Nice work. What?
Hey!
Well? What?
What?
Very nice. Boy, talk about a spry old man.
I can't wait to see him again.
You really?
of a lot of fish swimming around in this pond, huh?
Are they edible?
Sure, they're edible, but we've got no way to catch any.
Maybe something's going on in the forest.
I hate camping out.
Let's dispose of the trash.
Not in your dreams!
You're finished! Stop!
Here I come! Astral energy!
Say no more! Got it!
Well done!
Now! Take this! It's over!
Do it! Light astral energy!
My fists are crushing it out there!
I guess even someone as fashionable as you wouldn't know a whole lot about Danon armor, right?
Not really, no. Like, what's with that scarf? I don't remember that being with any of the armor we found back there.
Oh, well, remember how you told me you thought I'd look good wearing some blue? I took your advice to heart and decided to give it a go.
Oh, I see. Well, it suits you.
Would you say I've learned to spruce things up like you suggested?
I wouldn't go that far.
Rinwell, mind if we chat a little?
Hoodle, come here, sweetie. Hoo! Good boy.
What are you doing?
It's flying practice. Hoodle doesn't really like to leave my side, but if I don't make him spread those wings every now and then, they'll start to weaken. It's important he practices. Also, I'm pretty sure he put on some extra weight.
Oh.
Probably because everyone keeps sneaking him snacks when you're not looking.
I knew it! I thought there was something fishy going on. Oh, it's really not good for birds to be overweight, you know?
Oh, really? I'm sorry, Rinwell.
You were feeding him too? You haven't been giving him anything he can't eat, have you?
I'm pretty sure everything I've given him has been okay. Just to be sure, though, why don't you tell me what he can't eat?
Huh? Oh, yeah.
Is something the matter?
No, not at all. It's just, for a really long time, Hoodle was the only friend I had. So on the one hand, it makes me really happy to see everyone be so accepting. But on the other, it's a bit of an adjustment sharing him, you know?
Every one of us can see that he's like family to you. I can promise no one's trying to ignore your feelings or anything.
Yeah, I'm sure you're right. I'll talk to the others about it later. We should really get some rest. Another day, another gald.